that, what about this screen? So I want to talk about the universe map, which we've only barely implemented. It's just the very, very beginning of it. But this is it. So universe. So we have a star system that you're used to, where we go to the derelicts, and then we have the galaxy, which you're also kind of used to, where you're going around to different systems, if you will. It's as different star systems. But now we have this universe map, and why is it empty? Why is there no data? The idea is that you are going to travel around these galaxies, and I'm going to cheat here. I'm going to add some health. So you see how this right here has a ring around it, the star system number 2? I'm going to go ahead and travel to that. What that ring means is that there is a jump point or stargate there. So if I go into that, if we look at this, see down here, this funky looking thing? That is a stargate. So I'm going to go ahead and travel to that stargate since I have all these rations that I cheated and added. And it's going to ask me if I want to jump to Connected Galaxy 10, which, you know, is the name we currently have for our galaxies. I'm going to go ahead and say yes. So it's going to take a second, but you're going to, this map is going to change. And now all of a sudden we're in a completely different solar system because we've gone through this stargate. So now if we bounce out to the galaxy, you'll notice that the galaxy map looks completely different. Before, there was all this black space here and we were in the middle, and now we're off to the side and everything seems pretty filled in. And just to kind of reinforce that, here, I'm going to cheat a little bit and add some more rations and see if I can't. Okay, so yeah, so there seems to be like a big gap here where we can't get across, or there's nothing within range. This is one of those examples where maybe we would need to come back to this solar system, actually, which is a kind of a cool example. So let's go back to the universe map. And now, instead of no data, we'll see that Galaxy 10, which is what we just jumped to, and Galaxy 3. So we were here, and we jumped through the Stargate into this galaxy. But that's all we know. So I'm going to go back through this, back to Galaxy 3. I'm going to travel back through the Stargate. And now we're back here. And so what's cool about this is that you see when we jumped to Galaxy 10, how we ran out of room there, that our scanner wasn't big enough to get past it. And as I talked about before, maybe the idea is that on a future run, or even on this run, if we continue around here and we get a long-range scanner, maybe we're motivated to go back through to Galaxy 10 and see if we can't get further. Normally, you would maybe see... here, I'm going to cheat and add more rations. You would maybe find another galaxy eventually. And, of course, in this example, I'm probably not going to. all right. Perfect. Okay, so in theory you would find... Oh, wait, I totally missed it. Down here. See how there's another galaxy here with another Stargate? So we're going to go through that. And that'll take us to a whole new place. Galaxy 1. Yes. So we travel to Galaxy 1. We take a look, and it looks different than either of the previous galaxies we've been in. And we go to the universe view, and we can see now that Galaxy 3 is sort of in the middle here, and we were able to jump to Galaxy 10 and to Galaxy 1. And in theory, now from Galaxy 1, we could jump all the way to 10. So we're kind of unearthing this transit system. By the way, if you watch these videos and you watch these streams, there's a little bit of spoiling going on, just so that you know. Like, when you play Duskers the first time, that might be a moment when somebody realizes these things, and so I'm ruining all that, but such is life. So the idea here is that, okay, so now I'm in this new galaxy, and you can see here that there is another jump point, and I can go through that, and we start to fill in these connections. Of course, I'm completely cheating by adding a lot of rations to myself so I can just run around the galaxy or the universe, no problem. But now if we go to the galaxy map down here, and if we go to the universe, so now we're up here. So, all right. So this starts to look like a constellation. I will call this Tetris, the constellation. And the idea is, imagine if now we die. When we start a new run, and let's just go ahead and die. Restart. So let's imagine we died, and now we start a new run, and that was really bad, so let me do it again. Because it seemed like we started in the same galaxy. So now I restarted in a different galaxy. Actually, okay. So we only have 10 galaxies. So normally I would probably restart in a completely random galaxy I hadn't visited before. But because we only have 10, we randomly started in a galaxy that I think, because of this circle right here, we've been here before. Remember we teleported in here? Or we jumped in here and then we went up to this jump point maybe? Or no. Or maybe we just came in here. I don't know. Anyway, so now, in theory, when we went back to the universe map, this would be empty because we wouldn't know where... Or, okay, this wouldn't be empty. This would be here, but there would be a bunch of pages, and the page that we were on, we don't know where the heck we are. We don't know what universe we're in. Okay, hold on. So that's totally wrong. We would know what universe we're in because we happen to have landed in a universe that we've already spawned in. So... I'm going to restart again. Okay, now I'm in a completely new universe. And if you go to the universe map... okay, so this is all brand new. This has filled in how it's connected, but it wouldn't do that. Normally, we'd be able to look at this L shape, but when we went to where we were in the universe map, we'd have no idea. And we'd have to find a jump gate and then connect ourselves to this before we appeared on this map. So the idea is that you wouldn't know relative to all the other maps what you were. And so you'd have a bunch of maps where you've spawned, and you'd eventually find ways to connect those maps and all into one final map that makes sense across the universe. If that makes sense. So, right. So now we've spawned in this random place and we could add rations and travel to, travel to, Galaxy 3, which we've been to before. So this is how it would actually work. We would travel back to the galaxy that we've been to before. We'd be like, oh, that's where we were relative to all this other stuff. And like light would dawn and you'd be like, whoa, this is really cool. Hopefully. And now I have to just make decisions on what I'm going to do with all of this. Do I throw these MacGuffins in that says, hey, like, did you, like, there's this... On a ship log that you read, there's something that you really want on this spaceship in this system. And you visited that system before, and you're like, oh, I can get back there. Or you've never visited that, and you're like, oh, I guess I'll just keep an eye out for that system. And then that would give you motivation to either revisit places you've been before or and visit them in a new light or explore further and branch out. So I think that was kind of a long-winded way of talking about these universe ideas that I've talked about in my other videos. But this is the beginning of that.